Like, comment, share and subscribe.
Hawaii remains at constant threat from the potentially deadly Kilauea volcano, which continues to rumble on 1 month after a major explosive eruption. Here are all the numbers about the Kilauea eruption, which has buried two whole towns as 9,990 earthquakes struck. There have now been 35 days of ash clouds, earthquakes, lava bombs, and evacuations on Hawaii's Big Island since the Kilauea volcano erupted. The dramatic eruptions over the past month, since the first explosion on May 3, have forced more than 20 fissures to burst through the ground, sending lava fountaining into the skies. The obliteration of the Kapoho beach lots and vacation land subdivisions by a 15-foot-tall river of molten rock brings to at least 400 the number of homes and other structures consumed by lava during the past month. And officials with the United States Geological Survey, USGS, this week released some key statistics about the continuing eruption of Hawaii's Kilauea volcano. Here is everything we know about the Hawaii volcano eruption in numbers. 7.7 miles, the size of the square mile area covered by lava as of June 4, 2018. 24, the number of separate fissure vents that cracked up the land in Hawaii's Big Island. 4, a total of 4 lava flows have now reached the ocean, creating a deadly mix of lava, lava and haze. 656, the number of yards per hour of lava for the fastest recorded flow advance rate. 250 feet, the highest lava fountain measured after the eruption. 30,000 feet, the number of feet above sea level that the tallest ash plume was recorded as it spewed out the Kilauea summit. 9,900, the number of earthquakes on Hawaii's Big Island since the May 3 Kilauea eruption. 6.9 magnitude, the strength of the largest earthquake to strike the region since May 4 was 6.9 m. 35, the volcano entered its 35th day on Wednesday, and its destruction so far surpasses the 215 structures destroyed by lava during all 35 years of the volcano's last eruption cycle, which began in 1983. 279, the number of homes destroyed in the vacation land and the Kapoho Bay area. Vacation land is gone, there's no evidence of any properties there at all, Wendy Stovall, from the USGS, told reporters. Just a few homes are left standing, she added. Authorities began evacuating the Kapoho area last week, with most residents ushered to safety by early on Saturday, hours before lava severed all road access to the region. I just locked my doors and walked away, said Betty Oberman, a 28-year vacation land resident. It's an emotional roller coaster. A handful of residents who initially stayed behind rather than heed evacuation orders were airlifted by helicopter on Sunday. Most of the 24 volcanic vents have grown largely quiet over the past week, with just one, fissure 8, still spewing large volumes of molten rock from the ground as of Wednesday, the USGS said. That fissure is the origin of the lava flow that devastated Kapoho.